Hurricane Irene blew a tree onto our house August 27, 2011. After a night of mopping and bailing water when the sun came up, it was time to begin the long restoration of our roof and kitchen. We quickly realized that our restoration was only an inconvenience compared to the real disasters that many other folks experienced. We're grateful to our family, friends, and the many tradesmen who got us through the highs and lows of this unforgettable experience.
Take another one
because
there's holes.
Yeah. Hurricane Irene knocked us for a loop on August the 27th. Here it is, November the 28th, the night before demolition. Taking a kitchen out of service for a few weeks is entailing setting up an emergency eating facility. If anybody had any doubts that there's a lot of stuff in your kitchen, just look at this living room storage area. Well, it only took two good men about 3 hours to totally take out the old kitchen. According to the men who took apart the old kitchen, the electricians will be next. Possible paint colors always create a lot of stress to go with the decision. The electricians finished up today. We've got some new wires sticking out of the wall. and some new sockets in the wall to handle the different appliance layout. Our emergency kitchen setup's working pretty good. As you can see, we have some emergency meals fixed there, along with a little emergency dishwasher in the utility room sink. The roaring sound you can hear are two fans left by the drywall men. As you can see here, for the first time since August the 27th, we have a ceiling back in the damaged kitchen. This is real progress. Oh, one last thing I forgot to tell you was that we had to turn off the central heat because the house was filling up with dust all over. I just received instructions to cut the heat back on. The
first thing that happened this morning was two good floor men, along with some help from Carolyn and I, got the refrigerator down to the sunroom. As you saw, it took two men from about 9 o'clock this morning until now, about 3:30, to take up the old floor. And of course they ran out of tile, and you can see the areas against the back wall. They've got to check with the supervisor to see about getting some more tile and coming back and doing that tomorrow when they come back to put the grout. You could have seen me this morning at 6:30 walking outside and coming back with milk and creamer and orange juice through the backyard. I just hope none of the neighbors were watching. This is what I'm talking about. Two burly men arrived shortly after 8 o'clock this morning and brought all these boxes and this gear to put these cabinets into the house hopefully tomorrow. As I've said before, every time we take a step forward with progress, like receiving these cabinets, it seems like there's been an unintended consequence. This time the unintended consequence is we can no longer get to the utility room sink, which is where we've been washing dishes. Oh well, I guess I'll just miss washing dishes until they get these cabinets installed. Merry Christmas. The moon is right, the spirit's up. The feelings here that only comes this time of year. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having. As you can see, these cabinets are now fully in place. Men working from about 7 o'clock this morning until about 4. Got these cabinets out of the boxes, on the walls, and so one of the small things that I've really missed is having a trash can that's not sitting in the middle of the eating area.
I guess the question is what happens next? And we understand that the men to do the countertops, which of course will go right across here, will be here on Monday and do their measuring. You may recall that right after the hurricane in late August, Carolyn and I said to ourselves that patience was going to be quite a virtue, and that passions and emotions throughout this restoration process would go through some real peaks and valleys. Well, we've seen a lot of that since Monday. So let me take it one tradesman at a time, what's happened since Monday. On Monday, the countertop guy got here with equipment that looked like it could have been used in Star Wars, took the laser measurements for the new countertops, which was all quite positive. Then he told us that he didn't think but two guys back in the shop were working between now and Christmas, and that with most people off next week, it would probably be after the first of the year before the countertops were installed. A real downer. Then this morning, we get a call from the countertop persons saying they're coming to put the countertops in on Friday. So all of a sudden, we're back at the top of the emotions meter. You may not be able to tell this, but the painters were actually here today. The gentleman came to start a job that he's now estimating may take three or more work days. What you're looking at is not a bank of snow, but a painted ceiling. He also began stripping the backing off of wallpaper that was left on this wall right here, and cut in a little bit around this door frame and around his cabinets. He's going to have a nice holiday, and we'll be back next Tuesday. Appliance delivery, you may recall, was scheduled for yesterday, Tuesday. Well, nothing happened about by mid-morning, so Carolyn called. And of course, there was no record of the appliances being delivered. We also discovered that apparently they didn't have one of the appliances that we had picked out in immediate stock. So this set off another flurry of problems and emotions and cursing and all that. But ultimately, the appliances are scheduled to be delivered here tomorrow.
The long and winding road.
Look at what the painters have done since they were here.
Will never disappear.
Well, we just got back from our last Christmas celebration in South Hill and show you a few things that have taken place yesterday and today. You may notice the refrigerator here, a little Christmas elf helped us get this out of the Florida room and back up to the kitchen. And hopefully if we look behind it, we'd see it was hooked up again to the ice maker. But look at this beautiful faucet over here on their sink. It kind of looks like a bird sitting there. This is a happy new year. Besides the Arctic air, the plumber did arrive today as expected. And instantly today became a day of reclamation. As you can see, the new dishwasher is now installed. And to finalize, speaking of reclamation, check this out. The dog and I have our room back. The living room is looking much better. These are, believe it or not, empty boxes. And you can see a lot of the stuff has still got to be put away in the kitchen, but a lot of the stuff has gone back into the kitchen. Things were continuing to move along here. As you can see, the kitchen is beginning to take on its former glory. I hope no one's alarmed by the picture you're seeing of more construction. This is the backsplash tile. Here's the almost completed backsplash. The guys came today and finished putting up the tiles. You can see the decorative racing stripe through it.